It's time for the Giz Wiz with Matt's Maddest Rider, Dixie Bartolo. This is episode 1929, recorded Friday, March 31st, 2023. What a twist! On this episode of the Giz Wiz, Diggity has a new microphone system that he is testing out. A brand new dog dish. I have the last of my spring yard gadgets and your videos. All next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease.
Under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now, and here he is, the tip top gadgeteer, Dickie Bartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing good, sir. And you?
Doing great. Doing very good.
Excellent.
What have you
been up to? Boy, nothing thrilling. The auto show is coming next week, so I'm going to go to that. And you're getting set for your
Trip.
Your trip.
Recording this a day late. Because I just came back from a trip. I have today, tomorrow, and then I'm off on another trip, this time to Florida. And in Florida, we're going to be hosting a marathon, another marathon. We do a marathon in the fall. It's kind of our spring marathon now for Extra Life and Extra Life Charity and Children's Miracle Network of Hospitals. So looking forward to that. That'll be an entire week gone again.
Now, this is not where you rent a house, right?
No. So what we do is we rent that house and we raise money for charity. And this is the actual charity's convention. So they have lots of corporate partners. You know, they have champions who are the kids who have used the services of the hospitals that, you know, we're raising money for.
Oh, wow.
And they all come together and you know, there's panels. And the Extra Life side of the Miracle Network of Hospitals, the Extra Life side is all focused on gaming. So we have a gaming tournament. We have like a big stage, like performance type stuff. We interview some of the kids. We're going to be doing stuff to raise money.
Oh, great. So it's not at Disney World or anything. It's
no
totally separate.
Like at this point, 5 years ago, it was hosted at a Disney resort, but it had nothing to do with Disney World. And now it's just hosted nearby, I think just because of legacy, because it's always kind of been in the Orlando area. So it should be a ton of fun. It will not be, so I did the marathon with Mindcrack, but this is the official charity. So will all be Extra Life. So if you're Googling to try to find the live stream next week, then Extra Life. Extra Life is what you would have to Google to find the live stream and to find everything that we're doing. So it should be a lot of fun.
Good.
And I'll be hosting. So in the past, there was like other production companies that would manage this. And I wasn't super friendly with those production companies, but I would help out and stuff. And this year, I know the production company really, really well. And so I'm going to be hosting a lot. I'll be on camera a lot. This time around, where before I was like, I might just do one thing. This time I'm going to be like the host of the event.
Oh, wow.
So,
and
you'll
where
see
can we watch this?
So this would be extralife.org is their website. And I believe that it is twitch.tv/extralife. It may be extralife. Here, let me see. Extra Life for Kids. That's what I thought, is that there's a four kids in there. So this is the user page that I'll be live streaming on. And so this Extra Life for Kids event, and this will be the webpage that you tune into and would show
everything. Oh, great.
So Extra Life for Kids will be streaming on Twitch.
Very exciting. Very exciting.
And there's a little promotional video about Extra Life too, so you can find out more on that page. Extra Life
for
the numeral 4 kids. So yeah,
nice.
Looking forward to that. Well, you want to jump into some gadgets?
Yes, exactly. I think you'll be very interested in the first gadget.
It's from Anchor Work. And I may even have another thing to bring up after. That's exciting.
This is what it looks like, and here we go.
We unboxed everything that is in the wireless microphone, the M650 from Anchor Work.
I really hope this works.
This is the main unit here. All right, so when you open this box, it takes about 4 seconds, and everything turns on. I like the little receiver and the two mics.
That looks so slick.
On the side, and they are automatically matched. And this is really neat, is the way you put them on, okay? You can use a clip, or these are on with a really strong magnet.
Oh.
So you can then just put that behind there and clip it on.
Is that clever?
That is so clever.
To show.
Oh, Diggity, I'm so happy you have these.
This is. I don't think you're going to lose that, okay? So the two mics and the receiver. And all of these are charged automatically when they're in the case. Also in the case are two, what they call them, dead cat.
Yeah.
But something different. They plug into the jack on the device, okay?
No.
So you don't have to, like, slide it over the mic. However, this jack is the same jack you can use for an earphone if you want to monitor the sound, or you can use this jack if you want to use this as a transmitter and plug your own lavalier mic into this. All right. So that's pretty neat. Now, in here also is magnetically these two guys, USB-C. For your smartphone or for an Apple device, okay? And that guy matches up in the back. It latches on, you turn it, and it's locked into place. So this is good in case you're using both an Apple device and an Android device.
This is the perfect.
If you're using a camera, you
get the
cable. So
far, it's great, isn't it?
Yeah.
To hook up the camera, you get a carrying case, and a lot of branding on that, okay, Anchor Work. In case you want to change that, these are magnetic. You can switch to a goldish color, or this looks like black, but I think it's actually navy blue. 6 hours of use with the mics and the transmitter. With the case, it brings it up to 15 hours, okay? So that's going to be more than enough for your day.
The big question, what does it sound like?
I was taking a look at the app. I'm doing this myself, so it might be a little bit wonky here. You can set noise reduction. We have it on low. You can set it on stereo.
What?
Or mono. There's a graphic equalizer. You can set the screen time that you want on the transmitter. And then
the
you
receiver.
Can go over here to the microphones. You can set the gain for each microphone individually, and you can keep track of the storage. So this is kind of unique, is that each mic can record the audio independently of your camera or your smartphone.
What?
That way, if the audio is bad on the phone or camera, you have, I believe it's up to 7 hours of audio recorded on the mic itself, and you can go in here and download the files when there are files.
Okay, so we're in Riverside Park. There's a fair amount of traffic. I have the noise filter on low.
And no way.
And see how far I can get.
This sounds great, Dick.
Camera. Okay, I'm wearing.
Doesn't
the
it
mic.
Sound good?
Yeah.
And Charlie's going to stay here. Charlie, I'll be right back. Okay. Now, this is a place where I can watch Amtrak trains go by. All right. So there are tracks under here. And I know the Amtrak schedule fairly well. So it's what time is it now? It's 3:38. In 1 minute, a train should leave Penn Station heading for Chicago.
and it will pass under this grating, okay? I'm going to walk. There, of course, is the Hudson River.
Even on low, it really eliminated pretty much every sound.
It did.
4 years, we'll find out.
And this is the wireless connection.
And yeah.
This isn't the audio recorded on the mic, so that's impressive too.
The traffic, as I said, I have the low noise filter on. So this should sort of be a good test as hearing it. Almost no wind, a couple miles an hour. So that is it.
That's a motorcycle on the highway that got through a little bit.
Maybe I'll take the camera and shoot down and let you see the top of the train. So you can probably see a track down there, right? I can see one track in the viewer. And this is the Chicago Limited coming. And it should be six cars, okay? Chicago Limited coming. One, two, three, four, five, six. That was it. Six cars.
Wow!
Limited. Pretty neat. This is the Anchor Work wireless mic system.
Dick, I think
that's Charlie Dog right here.
I think this is it.
Andy Charlie said anything. Yeah, am I involved in this? Am I on camera? Should I do anything? Should I act cute? He says, I am permanently cute.
Dickie D, I think.
Pretty neat, isn't
it? We have found the holy grail of mic systems. Yeah. Finally.
And $250.
Yikes. That is, I mean, you had paid $150 for a brand we had never heard of.
Yes.
And it didn't have all these features. It didn't have on mic recording. It didn't have a jack that you could just switch out the mic. Like, it didn't have a lot of these features.
Exactly right. Now, I didn't listen. Sometimes with the software on the phone, it doesn't let you listen to audio as you're recording it. But this is set up to do that, but I didn't get to try that out.
It has
a lot of, I love that clip thing that if you don't want to clip it to a shirt, just unclip the clip, which is super magnetic, and put it behind your shirt and click the mic onto it.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That is awesome. And
set the gain for each mic. There's an equalizer for the mic. There's the whole system right there.
Wow. Yeah, that's very impressive. Let me see if I can find on here. I don't think so. Floating point is what I was looking for. Like, how many? I wonder what it records in the mic. Do you have to hit a button to start it recording?
You know, you mean to set the mic to record it on its own?
Yes.
Yeah, I don't know because I didn't use that feature. I just let
wireless.
Yeah, exactly. I just used the.
And then that app that we were looking at where you were managing did you just plug that into your computer?
Yes.
Okay.
For right now, I spoke to the people at Anchor Work, I think last Friday, and I said, I don't see the app on for Android yet. And she said, use the PC app or the Mac app.
Oh, wow.
And connect the USB-C cable directly to your computer, and then you can set whatever you want the mics to do or the unit to do. And she said probably within the next 2 weeks or so, the other app should be going online. So, so right now it's only through the web. And I noticed there's only 9 reviews so far. I think it's only been out for like 10 days or something now.
Man, that is actually crazy that they managed to finally kind of do everything.
Yeah.
That you need in a mic setup. I mean, it's everything. It feels like it's everything you need.
Yeah, and I was so worried that it was going to be super techy, and I mean, they just pair for themselves as soon as the case opens up. I think it's great.
That is great.
Originally, I just ran up and down the stairs to test the mic out, and then I thought, wait a minute, this says 656 feet. I said, let's go down the park.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
I can't wait until there's a tech event that you can use them at. I think that it'll really.
I'm going to take them to the car show.
Yeah, yeah, that's great. That's absolutely great. Yeah. Doug M. in the chat says, impressive demo, superior to the Rode. And I saw a few people talking in the chat that the Rode mic system is the most similar. And I don't have any experience with that system. But it does seem like the chat thinks that it's superior.
And doesn't DJI have a similar system, but it's
yes.
And that was, 350?
That was the one that I like kind of wanted you to get if you were going to get another one. Let me see what that cost. It looks like they're on Amazon here. And yeah,
$330.
Yeah. So this is less expensive, and I'm not sure if this would actually record on device or not. I forget if it would do that. It has a headphone. It has a jack as well, which is nice. It was really interesting that you could monitor the audio.
Yeah.
As well, which is great.
Yeah, it looks similar. It looks like it has a magnetic way to either put it on USB or for an iPhone connector. But it's still $75 cheaper. Yeah.
Yeah, that's great. That's amazing. I can't tell if it does it on mic or not, but either way, it does the 8 gigabytes of internal storage on the unit, on the wireless unit.
Oh, okay.
And then it can do uncompressed audio just like this one can do uncompressed audio, they mentioned. Very, very cool. That is an exciting gadget to get your hands
on. Pretty neat.
Yeah, that is very neat. Very, very cool. Okay.
All right, moving on to something a little more LED-y.
Nice.
Let's take a look. Welcome to Disco Dicks. Okay, if you're a fan of the show, you know I had a disco on a houseboat, and I spent, about 10 grand on lighting, and then Chad had a disco bulb, and then I bought a double disco bulb, and then Chad had a strobe, and then I bought two strobes. Well, now, in my studio in Disneyland, I have a ton of gadgets to make it a disco paradise. And that's a Dan Lutis song. I think it's called Party. We have to give Dan Lutis credit. Dan Lutis has done many Giz Wiz themes. And then I'm going to show you all the equipment I bought.
I see lasers,
effects,
and gobos, and lights. Yep. It seems like there's
so
a lot
everything
there.
Everything you saw, all those effects came from this one little box, okay?
Wow.
There are strobe lights built in. There's one of those LED, spinning LEDs that is like inside those bulbs that both Chad and I have. And then this is doing the LECOs that you see on the ceiling. Now, there's one thing to be aware of. When you turn it on, even if the bulbs are not running yet, let me just turn the machine off. The cooling fan will be running, but it won't be a problem because I'm sure there'll be music in the background and you won't hear it. So now I'm going to turn it on and demonstrate the different effects with the remote control. And then you can go into auto and you can do just one effect, which is those what are they called? LECOs?
Yeah. Gobos? I'm not sure.
You can
gobo, you might be a gobo,
to
yeah.
It if you want. And then this, I love this effect, okay? This kind of starry thing. And of course, the further away you get, I put this on the floor and it does my whole studio here.
And then you can just put in colors if you want to have red or green or a blue ceiling. And then it's just a plain old strobe. And then you can go into auto, which will put them all together. And then there's a speed control, and I haven't bothered using the speed control because I think it looks fine just the way it is. Okay, you know, I guess I can leave that running while I talk about it. The whole thing, all of those effects, $40. I was really amazed at this. It's the 40-watt strobe pattern, 5-in-1 stage light. It can be sound activated, so it can play with your music. Great for parties, and a little remote control. And I literally did spend thousands of dollars when I had the Disco Houseboat. It was a company, I got the thing from MGM Stage Lighting, and strobes were $150. So if you're doing a party, this is a really neat gadget for $40. That's it. Party on.
That is impressive.
Pretty neat. And DMX control fitting in the back if you...
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's impressive.
That's pretty astounding.
Yeah. Especially the DMX stuff. It's hard to just get... like a lighting fixture, one lighting fixture for $40.
Yeah.
You're basically getting, you know, six, because you got lasers, you got the gobos, you have the colors. I mean, that's crazy. Yeah. What is it? 5-in-1. You're getting 5.
5-in-1, yeah.
DMX 5.
I thought that was pretty neat.
I'd love to see. So if it goes to DMX, there's this DMX like sheet that it'll say, like, what channel everything is on. It's probably...
That's like a master control.
Exactly. And then
you, oh, I see.
So, like, okay. How DMX basically works is everything is a slider, and everything will have one address, but you can kind of match them all together. So if you want, you know, the fifth gobo, that would be slider 15, and the fifth position is this... little image, and the fourth position is this little image, and so then you add that to your software or your board, and then you can slide to what you want and save it and stuff.
Wait a minute, we have a first on the Giz Wiz. Scooter X telling us that we have a great buy,
yeah,
and that it is almost twice the money on AliExpress.
AliExpress is expensive.
Oh my gosh.
You're getting it almost half price.
Yes.
That's crazy. Wow. That's crazy.
Wow.
That's
why don't we buy
impressive.
1,000 and sell them to AliExpress?
Exactly. Exactly. That's what we got to do.
Yeah. Pretty neat.
That is really cool. Oh, so there's a 40-watt, a 45-watt, which I guess would change the face of it.
Oh, you know,
45-watt, and then a 60-watt.
It is slightly different.
Yeah,
it is different. Slightly different, yeah.
Well, that's impressive. That's really, really cool. Disco in a box, basically.
Yes, exactly right. And it comes with a bracket. You can hang it on the ceiling or stand it on a shelf or just lay it on the floor. It's pretty neat. All right, we saw Charlie in the video for a second when we did the mics. So we're going to see Charlie again and explain about how Charlie wolfs down food. Here's that video.
This is Charlie's dinner, and we have a little problem with Charlie, is he tends to eat a little bit on the fast side, as you'll see. So let's put the dinner down on the floor.
Give me that.
As soon as he stops running around. All right, so Charlie eating dinner. Take one. Okay.
Nom, 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 nom.
There he goes.
Yes. So
Notice how he carefully eats and savors each morsel. Okay, and
He's like the Houdini
we're halfway through dinner. And we're only at 33 seconds.
Yeah.
And now he's I can't down to the end of his dinner, 45 seconds. And he's just about.
He's pretty tidy about it. Done.
He's tidy.
So why am I doing this?
Is, but my God, how could he?
You know,
possibly?
Those slow feed dishes have been around.
Yeah, crispy bacon.
But I bought one called. I don't know why
don't
they call it the tornado.
Him. No,
but we needed proof of Charlie eating his. What has he got? One, two muscles left, and he made it to like a minute and 10 seconds.
Yeah, that whole plate of food.
You saw how fast Charlie ate that. So we decided to get another slow bowl. So I went over to Amazon. I had one years ago. I don't know what happened to it. So I got the slow feed. Now, why would they call it the tornado bowl? Wouldn't it be
it's a marketing
called, like,
breakthrough.
The slow as a snail bowl? Anyway, more than 600 ratings, 4.6 ratings, 4.6 out of 5 stars. From more than 600 people. And I checked through it. Only two dogs rated it. And both dogs rated it 1 star because it slowed them down too much. So this is a guesstimate of about how much food he had last time. Okay. And then we're going to put it in the tornado bowl. And Dennis had a good idea. He said it probably called the tornado bowl because it looks like a tornado, the wind. Okay. All right, and Charlie's been going berserk while we're making this. All right, okay, hang on.
Give me a little hillage.
We go down to the test kitchen.
All right, so Dennis and I, Charlie doesn't like anything new. And see, at first he steps back
him.
And he goes, wait a minute, this is not my regular bowl.
Yeah, but he flinched then, a bit right there, I feel.
Oh, I
yes, exactly. He doesn't like anything new, and we thought, he'll probably just walk away from it.
You know
but
what?
Then
I think this is going to be a good thing. I think this is going to be a good thing because it's already 30 seconds.
And he's only a third of the way through his dinner.
Yeah, he's definitely thinking about it more. He's moving from spot to spot.
He's getting into the groove.
Yeah, getting into the grooves, exactly.
But, all right, we're coming up almost to how much time he spent last time. Is there enough light there, Dennis? Okay. We're coming up to the minute mark. I'm very happy because already we're more than a whole extra minute.
He's almost done.
He normally eats his dinner. So we can just end it there because he'll eat the last few morsels. And this is great. All right.
Mission accomplished.
Yeah, so he went from a minute and 10 seconds to 2 minutes and 40 seconds. So, and also, it just seems like he'll be forced to digest his food a little bit better.
Yeah.
Because he didn't wolf it down. Also, there is a bizarre, it doesn't say cat bowl, does it? Mine had cat bowl toward the bottom. Go down a little more. Cat bowl.
Oh.
Look at the cat bowl.
Oh, that's so funny. Well, you put it down there, and they have to scoop it out.
Oh, yes, that's what they...
They're using their paws to scoop it out of the base. Oh, that's so funny.
Isn't that a riot?
Yeah.
It looks like a flying saucer.
It does.
Anyway, it's the cat bowl is $15.
What is it? The tornado Frank's- as well? Let's see. Is there a flying saucer in the name?
No, just interactive cat.
No, interactive cat.
Yeah. Boy,
the dog gets the...
Yeah. And it's only one size, and there's only one color. But it worked good for Charlie for $11. Oh, and there are a ton of other companies these things.
That's great. This fantastic.
One was fun. Yeah.
There we go.
In the kitchen.
Tornado. Okay, well, with that, let's move on into...
You know you don't need it, but you might want it at Chad's Crappy Corner. Get it.
Okie dokie, we have the last of our gadgets. Here it is. I recorded a video earlier, so let's check out the video. Hey Diggy D, so we are here with the last of my spring garden yard gadgets. And this gadget is for the garden, but maybe a little bit more. These are basically bulk twist ties. So on the back here, you have a big spool of twist tie. You can put it underneath this metal part and then push down and it will snap off the twist tie so that you can use it. In gardening, you would use this to maybe stick a stake in the ground and then use these twist ties to twist a plant into that stake to make sure that it doesn't go anywhere. But I'm sure that most people are seeing these and thinking that they could use them in other ways. And specifically, let's say you have a big old loaf of bread, tons of slices, and you've opened it and you've lost that little plastic thing. Well, of course, you can use a twist tie to twist that up, or just really anywhere that you would use a twist tie in normal life, except that you can cut it to the exact length that you need. So that is this week's gadget. Dun, dun, dun. Okay. It's
Boy,
pretty 300 simple.
300 feet.
Yes. It is. That's a kind of a big plus, is that it's 100 meters, so 300 feet. And it's only $8.
Wow.
This feels like a buy it for a lifetime. I mean, I don't think I need twist ties that often. And so when I do, I just have this available to fulfill all my twist tie needs. Look, they even show electronic gadgets, you know, cables being twist tied up.
Looks like it did great in the rating, too.
Yeah, look at that. 6,000 ratings. Oh, no. It's a twist tie disaster, mechanical issue. So it was, I did notice the first time I pulled this out, everything was kind of wacky, but they give you an obvious place to pull, and that's how, you know, you get this started.
So it comes in the center?
Yes, it does. So here we go. There it is. This is, you know, the center, and so it'll spool out from the center.
Oh, I see.
And then you can place it underneath this metal clip, push the metal clip, and there's a pretty audible snap. There you go. And now I have my twist tie that I can use for whatever. So yeah, there you go. I made a really long one that time. So yeah, I think that it's great. Oh, apparently Scooter X is telling me that the colored plastic bit that I was saying that you might lose and you would use the twist ties for, they have meanings? What the color tags on your bread actually mean?
What?
I had no idea.
Neither did I. I thought it just meant a different date. Oh,
wait,
it does
what?
Mean a different date. Yeah.
Monday, Tuesday, Thursday. What? This can't be every single bread company, can it? Red Friday. Okay.
That is...
I don't know. This doesn't seem like every single bread tag. Like, not every bread maker is using this exact...
No, I don't think so.
Right?
No.
Anyway, that's
Hell
pretty cool.
No, I just came out of the bakery. What tag? Well, it's Tuesday.
Oh my gosh, look at that. He also, Scooter X also found... And all I, this is, we're back to reality, back to normal here. $2. Now it's only 20 meters. Oh, it looks like I can choose the difference. Oh, 30 meters. See, we have 100 meters. $6.80. It is $1 shipping. So Amazon is actually less expensive.
Wow.
Again.
Wow.
At $7.99. Versus six plus two, basically.
Oh,
six,
my. Yeah. Eight.
Yeah. It's definitely more expensive. And you'll get it April 25th, where I'm pretty sure I ordered this next day.
Yeah.
I think I got this tomorrow. Within 12 hours from placing the order. So, yeah, there you go. Twist ties.
Oh, I like that.
A good option for gardening and for use in the kitchen. With that, let's head on over to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Our email is from Linda Norman, who says, "Hi, Dick and Chad. I made a video about an Amazon find I came across while searching for an EDC flashlight."
Huh.
Not quite. I don't know what that is.
Is that like the chip on board?
Maybe.
Type of like documentation?
I'm not sure. These turned out to be a really good deal. Plus, they're LEDs. I love the show, Linda Norman. And here's her video.
And Nick with a C says EDC stands for everyday carry. So something you could keep on keys. Something that you could just throw into.
Boy, our chat room is so smart.
Very smart. This is great. Okay, so here is the video.
Okay, and she talks a little bit before we see something.
I was looking for something not too long ago, and what I was looking for was a little flashlight that I could carry around with me on my keychain. And I've had these before. They're just, you know, tiny little flashlights that use those really annoying little button batteries.
I hate those.
And I was looking for something different.
They take
a
million pounds to turn on.
This is what I found.
Oh, there's so many.
Came in a box.
So many.
Lots and lots and lots of them.
I didn't expect that.
But basically what it is, get that out of the way, is this. All right. It's a small little flashlight that you can put on your keychain. And if I throw a ruler in front of it here, you can see it is pretty small. It's only about 2 inches. And that's 55 millimeters, for everyone else in the world. But a little 2-inch flashlight. It's not super bright, but it's bright enough for what I need. If I turn it on here, you can see. All right, you get a pretty good spot. And it lasts for a little ways out. I mean, I'm really looking for something to light up, like, my door at night when I come home.
Like a sidewalk.
Just so I can see what...
or a menu.
Where I'm putting my key, or, you know, looking for something in the car when, you know, glove box or something. I can stick it in there. Anyway... these things have a couple of things going for them. They are small. They come with a little key.
I like that.
Fob instead of the thing here.
Typical loop.
And
it's like a carabiner.
Best part, hang on, is they charge via USB.
What?
And this is regular USB-A. So you can plug this into your laptop.
What a twist!
You can plug it into a power brick.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be little button batteries.
Yeah, a little while. I found these on Amazon.
It's on the back. How does that work?
And I've got the Amazon. Where'd the Amazon ad go? Here we go. There's the Amazon ad. You get 12 of them for $21.99. That's less than $2 a flashlight. Even after tax was added in New York, it was less than $2 a flashlight. I think I'm going to start giving these away to friends and maybe keep one in my car, keep one... you know, around the house, but I thought these are pretty cool. And they're LED, which, you know, makes them perfect for the Giz Wiz.
Of course.
LED flashlights.
Rolling, glowing LEDs.
So that's my Amazon find. Thanks a lot.
That is perfect. Love the video quality.
Yeah, I like that. I love the charge USB. I hate flashlights.
That was such a twist, because that's the button that I thought was pressed to turn it on. And that's also the USB
end cap.
Yeah. I may have missed. Maybe you twist it to turn it on.
Maybe.
I don't know exactly how it works.
I think it's a great buy.
That is amazing. really is cool.
Oh yeah, I've got great reviews.
Too. Oh, look at them! Look, they're plugged right in to a little thingy. Oh, that's great. I love that. Great, yeah, great find. Great. Great
Linda, find. Thank you for that. You'll get the current issue of Mad Magazine. And we're looking for more videos. Okay. Anything to do with a gadget, like Linda, a current gadget that you just bought and got me to buy, or a gadget that you bought and hate. But we especially love when you have an old gadget in the attic or the cellar or even in a drawer. Some old tech gadget that was a big deal when you bought it. And now it's a joke, but it was so expensive you can't throw it out. A little video, 1 to 3 minutes. You can be in it if you want or just describe the gadget. Use landscape mode and put it up on YouTube. And there's a drop-down menu. Click unlisted and you'll get a URL and send that to us. mail@gizwiz.tv. mail@gizwiz.tv. Anything to do with a gadget.
Love it. With that, let's move on to the letter.
We count the letters, your lovely letters. We count the Giz Wiz letters now.
Okay, Eric Murray writes with the subject line, Forget Five Below.
Oh.
And he says, Dick and Chad, a recent visit to Glasgow in Scotland, I came across a store which beats Five Below. And being in Scotland where the weather is rain, snow, and wind, 363 days of the year, maybe the name of the store is more to do with the average temperature than the sale price of items. I give you one below.
What? 1 euro or less
is 1 pound or less, and they have 4,000 items that are equal to 1 pound.
I didn't realize there was 4,000 flavors of gum. I just it's kind of impressive. What do you buy for a pound? I mean, it's got to be like a postage card.
Yeah. So I emailed him and I said, well, do you buy anything? And he emailed back. He said, oh, I did buy something from the store for 1 pound. It's the best gadget for work. It's the 5-in-1 pen. It is 4 different colored pens plus a technical pencil all in the one pen. Now I want more of them, but I can't find them anywhere in the city where I live.
Gotta go to Glasgow.
Yes. I attach a photo of the best pen in the world. Keep up the great work. Derek from Inverness.
Oh.
The Loch Ness Monster's neighbor.
Okay, wait a second. There may be an update. One below. Uh-oh. This is a website that looks very similar, but it's called One Beyond. Do you think the American Five Below had a conversation?
Isn't that funny?
Oh, maybe this is $1 and up, or 1 pound and up, because I'm seeing two. Maybe it's
maybe this is different. just type in 5-in-1 pen.
Oh yeah, true. Here, let me try
see if,
that.
See if
there's no search.
Oh, what? There.
There's no search here.
Yeah, I've seen that happen where inventory changes so fast, they figure, you know, right. By the time you get here, it's not going to be here.
Right. Wow. I'm wondering if this is connected, though.
Is One Beyond.
Sorry. Exactly.
Yeah.
Amazing value for only a dollar or for a pound. And that was one below because everything is below a pound.
Yeah.
What is this, only 4 pounds?
Oh, yeah, wait a minute. What
is going on here?
Five below. Then they have five above. And then they have.
Can't tell what's going on. Did they change the name and just this photo, you know, is. you know, they haven't gotten around to changing the sign on the building, but it is now the One Beyond company.
It looks that way.
That's very funny.
Anyway, Derek, thank you. That's great fun.
That's great. Hey, everybody, thank you so much for watching, and I want you to support us over at patreon.com/gizwiz. Huge thank you to all of our supporters. Thank you so much for supporting our show. We really appreciate it, and we're really grateful for all of your generosity. Thank you so much. If you'd like the show, please consider giving back over at patreon.com/gizwiz, or you can head on over to gizwiz.tv, click on the Patreon tab. There's a big old banner there that'll take you to our Patreon page, or there's a little link for PayPal if you want to donate via PayPal. However you donate, thank you so much. Speaking of gizwiz.tv, that's where you can watch the show live just about every Thursday, 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern time. We are on a bit of a different schedule right now. We will be live tomorrow, same place, same time, just a different day because I'll be heading to Florida. The website just updates with the live stream, so just head on over to gizwiz.tv and it'll be updated around 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern time. And if you don't miss it live, all of our episodes are there on the website. Head on over to gizwiz.biz. That's Dickie D's website where he writes up articles about all of the gadgets that we cover on the show. So if you need to learn more, need to find a link, gizwiz.biz is the place to do it. While you're there, play What the Heck Is It? This is the game show online where you gotta guess the gadget. And this is obviously, this is a hole punch for fruit punch. To get the punch into the fruit so you can make some fruit punch. If you think you know what this is, get a guessing over at gizwiz.biz. Six Mad Magazines for funny, clever, hilarious, or interesting... No, Six Mad Magazines for correct answers. 12 Mad Magazines for funny, clever, hilarious, or interesting answers. So it pays to be funny over at gizwiz.biz. That about wraps it up for our show. We'll see you next week.
I'll be here.